And now here at the Shell Eco Marathon in Houston, Texas, with Wayne Gredes, the holder of several Guinness World Record for fuel efficiency. How are you, Wayne?
I'm good, and nice to have you along, Javier.
Well, thank you very much first for bringing us along here to the Shell Eco Marathon in Houston. It was a great experience. I had come before, but this year was kind of special. I don't know, like, because it's the last year in Houston, because it's moving along, and because even 2 years from the past one that I came, I mean, the things that we've seen are amazing here with these kids making like crazy numbers.
Harold, you know, not only are you a friend, but you're kind of a fuel economy aficionado as well. And what we do on the open road, it pales in comparison to what these kids do. They're orders of magnitude beyond what I can do.
So the thing that I want to take away from this Shell Eco Marathon is, I mean, in short, like, there's hope, right? For the industry, for the world, for kids. I mean, everything. I mean, when you see these kids, the energy they have, they are 15-year-olds, 16-year-olds, 17-year-olds, beating like college students. So, I mean, the college students are really good, but then when you see high school students beating them and like making these incredible machines, it's there's hope, right?
There's not only hope, but they're doing it on shoestring budgets. These high schools, they have a few hundred bucks if they're lucky. They might find a motor, they might find an engine on eBay for, you know, 1/10 of what it would normally cost. They might find something in the garbage somebody threw away, and they're bringing this, making these hyper-efficient vehicles that are not only roadworthy and pass all the tech inspection requirements of the Shell Eco Marathon Americas, but then they're getting a fuel economy that's ridiculous. Yeah, I am so proud of all of them.
So let's review a little bit. I don't remember all of them because actually there were a lot of categories. I think there are six, and then they give awards for three of in each one of them. Mm-hmm. But I think in the gasoline category, it was, I'm trying to remember as we speak, like over 2,000 miles a gallon?
2,700 miles per gallon. I mean, you're talking crossing the United States, not on a tank or two tanks, on a gallon. It's ridiculous.
And for the audience, we have to explain a little bit how those cars are. I mean, the cars is pretty much a capsule on wheels for one person who is pretty much laying down horizontally, and then they make them as efficient as I mean, it's not comfortable, but it's like very, very efficient, right?
Very efficient. Of course, there's no air conditioning in there. Yeah. There's no suspension. But regardless, it's the numbers that are just so phenomenal, and it astounding to even be part of this. Yeah. And here we are. We get to report on this. We get to see it, and it's amazing.
So Shell has been doing this for a long, long time. Over like almost like the original idea came like 70 years ago, and then they've been doing it in Europe for like 30. Here in the States for 8, and they started in California, they came to Houston for 5 years, and now they're moving to Detroit. Mm-hmm. So what do you think Shell is involved in this? I mean, it might be obvious, but what's your opinion on that?
Well, you know, when you think of an oil company and you think, oh boy, that's oil and all they want to do is big profits.
Yeah.
What I'm finding with Shell, and again, I just do minor sponsorship, you know, can you give us some fuel to do an event drive? These people go out of their way to make sure that there is an efficiency side and a safety side to everything that they do. And it's not just about money, it's about making the world a better place. And the more that I work with them, the better and more confident I feel to work with them.
From the executives we talked to here in Houston, they were talking about how they work with oil, they create gasoline oils for engines and all that, but also they take care of water, and like they invest in that, like to see how it can make even that use of that more efficient and for a longer time, right?
Right, and just think, when we were in some of those venues, what was the first thing that the Shell exec, went before we even started any of the presentations or anything, the first thing they did was a safety talk.
Yeah.
You know, and that is, I've seen that multiple times. Even think about walking down the stairs, there was a sign, hold the rail.
Yeah.
When we drive the vehicles under Shell, we can't talk on the phone. That's just the safety culture, and it just shows you where they're heading with the environmental aspect of oil production, and it's a good thing. And from what I've seen so far,
on that aspect also, it was cool to see the kids. I mean, like, they gave awards to kids who like reinforced those those rules of safety around the convention center here in Houston, like, for example, making everybody who walk into the work area wear safety glasses and those kind of things. So, yeah, they're conscious about that, and they really put a big effort in that, too.
Yeah, and again, you got to thank these kids. Think of what you were doing at 14 years old.
Oh, it was
not building hyper-efficient cars and wearing safety glasses, sure.
No. I was doing something up.
Yes, we all were, trust me.
Mainly playing soccer, I have to say. It wasn't that bad. I did some bad stuff, but not that bad. So, great event, Shell Eco Marathon here in Houston, moving it to Detroit. But now you're driving to Detroit in this very special car. Talk about that aspect of this event, please.
Yeah, well, being tasked with first going to the Shell Eco Marathon as an invitee, and I was flabbergasted. As I invited you and some others, I am so glad that you could come down to cover this and enjoy the experience. But the second part of this is we're taking a brand new 2014 Ram 1500 4x4 with the EcoDiesel. It's got about 26 gallon fuel tank, and we're going to try to drive it over 1,000 miles on a single tank of fuel. Now, Shell is getting a little promotion out of this because they're releasing in a small market this new Shell diesel called Shell Diesel Fit, and the Fit stands for fuel injection technology. It's more detergents to keep your diesel injectors clean, to give you better fuel economy down the road. Start using it early, walk through.
They've done that with gasoline with hydrogen, right?
V-Power.
Yeah, the V-Power, yeah.
High nitrogen.
Nitrogen.
So they're moving into this branded diesel, and it's going to provide a cleaner diesel for the vehicles that we're driving today as we drive them for the next decade.
So this car is officially rated for what? Like about 22?
Yeah, it's rated at 19, 27, 22 combined.
So how are you
going to
do this?
Well, we're going to be really careful. Some of the things that Ram has provided.
Give us your tips in general, not for this only this drive, but in general, how can you be like really efficient while driving your car?
Okay, well, we're going to be right-hand lane drivers, and we're going to stay between the speed limits. If it might have a bottom of 45 and a top of 65 or 70, we'll be traveling between, like, let's say 52 and 60 miles an hour in a far right lane in what's called a ridge ride to make you more visible.
Yeah.
And what I'm going to do is try to maintain engine load, not speed of the vehicle. Like most people think, you hit cruise control and just let it go. Well, we don't do that. And one of the examples is driving with load. As we see an overpass ahead, whoever's driving, I'm gonna dictate with my discussion on how to control the vehicle. We're gonna maintain engine load to stay the same as we're climbing the overpass.
Okay.
62, 61, 60, 59, 58 is where the top, 59, 60, 61, 62 on the backside. The engine never saw a change. We had a small droop, and then the pickup, the engine didn't know the load changed or speed changed. It just did what it was supposed to at a very efficient rate. That's going to be one of our techniques that we're going to use out there.
Well, I know what others are like in general, not only for this drive. How should people drive to... I mean, they're not gonna break any records like you do every weekend, almost.
No, I don't
but like in 1 minute, like what will be your 1 minute tips for people to drive around?
Okay, let's talk about aggressive acceleration and deceleration, meaning you're always on the gas or you're always on the brake. You don't need to be. When there's a red light ahead, there's no reason to keep on the gas and drive right up. It doesn't matter what's going on around. You'll reach it, and if it turns green by the time you get there, you never had to stop.
Yeah.
You're going to save on brakes. You're going to save on tires. Let's talk about how we handle traffic that stop and go on your daily commute. You want to open a buffer ahead of you as they're accelerating away, and then when they stop, you smash the buffer. So you maintain 10, 15 miles an hour as they're going 0 to 30, 0 to 30, 0 to 30.
Excellent. Well, Wayne, we're getting to the end of this show. The whole show was dedicated to cover the Shell Eco Marathon show. Thank you very much again for bringing us here. And very quickly, can you give where can people follow you and read your stuff and all that?
Oh, thank you, Javier. And it was great to have you here. Wayne Gurdes is my tag and my name, but it's cleanmpg.com.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much again, Wayne. And we're going to end the night here in Houston. And we're going to share with all the audience and all our followers on Twitter and Facebook and YouTube and all that, all the great things we did here in Houston this weekend. And good luck on this trip. And let's talk next week about how you did about it.
Okay. Thank you, Javier.
Thank you very much. Y con esto llegamos al final de esta edición especial de Auto 060 aquí en Cristina Radio Network, con el Shell Eco Marathon 2014, que el año próximo tendrá su edición en Detroit. Así que nos veremos allá. Yo soy Javier Mota, esto es Auto 060.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.